hit them like a Tetris. You felt the way and all you do is text and listen. I don't know why they mentioning beef. I don't think no one better than me. You would say what you want, but my step is on speak. If I tell them to go, then they stepping on three. Like, bought a chain that's competitive. Me making rain in your hood like I weather the streets. My label we good, I'ma get to the breach. You only as tough as your weapon could be. I done caught me a dealing, I got off the block. Took the hate and put that in the watch. Had the ice on my neck, cause I'm surely on hot. If some rabbits that want me to flap, I don't care about no dissing, cause none of them pop. And I'm shooting my stars with a pop. They be all on my DM, like when you gon' drop. Look, it get boring, just me at the top. It get boring, just me at the top. I be shaking their hearts every time that I drop. Like, when I walk in the spot, it's a, you won't be in this. If you don't make it hot, like, huh. New deal, AP, I done signed up with Def Jam. Jay-Z, got the in my left hand. Play me every time that I step them. Hate me like what? Play with the gang and you play with your life. With a bag in your head, it don't matter the price. Put on their neck, so I got me some ice. If I'm dissing you once, I ain't saying it twice. Said I got time today, I done stepped in the fit. I got time to play. And my exes are the bear, time to wait. Blocking, I said I need time away. Like, what you mean you don't know how I'm stepping? What you mean you don't know what I'm repping? I'm filling my hood like they call me the blessing. You jacking my side, you gotta come and check in. That's the way I get hectic. Don't make me slide up on you, no electric. Blocking, hit them like it's Tetris. You felt the way, and all you do is text and listen.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium.
Today, we've got a good one on tap in the AFC North as it'll be the Cleveland Browns taking on the Baltimore Ravens. Justin Tucker, the kickoff.
Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium.
Here's Jakeem Grant from his end zone.
And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14. They start on the ground with Nick Chubb. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. Here's Watson, option left. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Give him 4 yards as he does it himself, and it's a first down.
So that was all you're looking for on a play like that. Get the first down and keep the drive moving.
Yeah, it just looked to me like he just said to himself, I've got this. I'll take it. I'll pick it up, and let's keep moving. Get the first down, get a new set, and let's start over.
And holding it may be the wrong decision as he stopped in the backfield. It's a loss of 5 there, bringing up second.
I don't think there's any doubt that if it's me, I'd be really cautious about continuing to call this play because you got to know, defenders, if they get a free shot at the QB, they want to take it, and they want to take it big.
And they got it there on the option play for a loss. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there.
I don't think anyone thought we'd see a run facing second and that long, and that element of surprise, I think, helped make that play so successful. Nice effort on that carry, and it took what seemed like second and impossible. Now has him within throwing range of a first down.
And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. It's a gain of 10, and the Browns are going to get a first down.
If you're these receivers, you got to be ready, because when he's going to throw it quick on that RPO, he's going to throw it quick.
And this is why you spend time with your guy either in the offseason, during the week, the whole bundle. Because sometimes it's just telepathy. You both see the same thing, and he knows, get the ball to him right away.
The first down run with Chubb is going to go nowhere. He's, in fact, going to lose a couple. So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Faking the give. Now Watson. Got an open man. That's David Njoku, the tight end. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Watson on first down. Right back to Njoku. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
It's
To throw on second is Watson. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Excellent defensive effort to get to him and provide a little contact before the catch could be made cleanly.
This will probably be the last play of the quarter. They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. No score after one on EA Sports. The start of the second quarter, and it's the Browns in control of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. Play fake, and it's Watson. Bryant has it. And the stiff arm made it a pretty little run. Not a huge game, but a nice chunk of yardage.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there? Freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Now Watson. No, he doesn't have it. Maybe some alligator arms here going over the middle. Third down.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
This offense has converted two third downs on this drive already. This is third and four. Watson, off play action. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. Oh, they're changing this at the line. On fourth down, Watson. 1:57 to go in this first half on EA Sports. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their own 37. Jackson now. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
Tough series for the passing game. Things just aren't clicking. Hoping they can come through on this play and get this series back on track with a completion for enough yardage for a first down.
Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on third.
This defense has certainly played well so far in this game, and the coverage has been tight. And just about every throw forced a few here so far in this game. And now it brings up fourth down.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. And just a 30-yard punt that time. And the Browns will take over first and 10. The Cleveland offense ready to go.
A kind of a lucky break on the prior drive, Charles. The turnover on downs that the offense had didn't come back to bite them after the other side, their defense, came through, was able to hold them without any points.
I would agree with you, partner. A little bit of a lucky break indeed, but you know what they'd say to us? No luck, just pure skill. We rose to the challenge, and we didn't permit a score. That's how we roll.
Well, I'm kind of curious, Charles, if they might temper their aggressiveness now.
Oh, the ball is out. Watson lost it, and it's picked up by the Ravens. And down inside the red zone at the 19-yard line. And a defensive-minded coach loves to turn up the heat, turns it up there, and pays off.
And back in the good old days, those defensive-minded coaches just talked about intimidating teams, using force, right, beating them to the punch. In this case, they talk about creating turnovers. That's all they preach, all game long, all practice long, every meeting, get the football. That's what they want.
They went three and out on their first drive. Things already looking better here, first and 10. Jackson on the move to his left.
He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
I think the defense surprised him there with that blitz on first down, but give him credit. Stayed cool under pressure and still found a way through the extra rushers for positive yardage. Well done.
A shotgun snap and a give to Dobbins. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down.
Report.
Now it's Jackson. He'll buy some time right. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1. Pretty solid gain of 7 yards that time as he scrambled, but now they face a 4th down.
And defensively, they had an extra defensive back on the field, their nickel package, and it made a difference. All the receivers were blanketed, so he tried to run for it, but he came up just a bit short.
The offense is staying out there. Here we go on 4th and goal from the 1. They're going for it with Dobbins. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Baltimore. J.K. Dobbins taking it in from a yard out. And the Ravens post the first points of the ballgame as they take the lead here in this second quarter. So that, Charles, a big decision there on 4th and goal, and it works out.
And that is an example of a coach who's confident in his team. He didn't look at it as a gamble at all. He looked at it as belief. Great starting field position. Let's go ahead and deliver. And they do.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Browns drive about to get started. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out.
He's got a man complete. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. And that one results in 35 yards.
And this is how you answer a touchdown on the other end. You come out throwing to start your own drive. And not just throwing, but pushing it down the field. And they come up with a big play as they try to answer back with a score of their own.
It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down.
Brandon, I think he's just grateful to get back to the line of scrimmage and avoid not just losing yardage, but a big hit on that play as well. That defense closed on him quick and forced a quick surrender out of bounds.
Now a 2nd and 10. Here's Watson. Incomplete, and we're down to 8 seconds now.
Going with a dime look on defense. 2 extra defensive backs on the field have covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
So now 3rd and 10, a big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Here's Watson. Flush to his right. He's got his target. That's complete. And the timeout comes in with 2 seconds remaining. So they can trot out the field goal unit for the try before we hit the lockers. Hopkins' kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. That's it for the first half. 2 more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. The Ravens ready to receive it, and they've got the lead as well as we resume play in the second half. Hill is going to take it out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. No gain on the play there. Second down. Well, if you look where that play starts, O-line versus D-line, that was a battle won by the D-line.
Yeah, and oftentimes it's won by quickness off the ball. Who can handle the guy across from them best? On that play, the defensive line did exactly that.
Out to his left. And he'll be out right at the 35. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a first down.
And Brandon, this is the time of the game when Jackson can really take over. He's got the defense's legs a little bit tired. He's got them on the run.
Yeah, this defense looks gassed, and you're exactly right. Second half.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Jackson hit and he lost the football. Dangerous spot for them to cough it up. Lucky to have recovered, because had the defense gotten it, they were already within a shadow of the goalpost.
Yeah, and then you're yelling at your own defense, sudden change. That's not what you want to hear on your sideline. That means you got to run out there and try and stop an offense who has the ball in a very advantageous position.
On third down, it's Hill. A crazy sequence here. A huge gain that time, but it still leaves him well short for fourth down.
For a running back, that's kind of depressing, right? You get all that yardage, but still no first down.
Well, it was a mile, maybe a mile and a half, to the first down mark.
Yeah.
So he did all he could to get there. A little disappointing at the end, but boy, they gave it a great effort, didn't it? Gotta give him a little respect for that, don't you?
And he really helped his yards per carry average, that's for sure.
Yeah, quietly, he'll take that.
Well, that looked for a second like he might take it all the way, but as it stands, it's still a massive return.
And the Browns have a short field in front of them now as they take over first and 10.
Here's Nick Chubb as they try to fire up this run game. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. The Georgia man, Roquan Smith, came in and got it.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Here's Watson now on second down. This complete to David Bell. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And now third down and 6 to go. Throwing on third down, Watson. Right back to Bell, and it's caught once again. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number 3. 3 quarters in the books. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Baltimore. It's the Browns with a deficit. They're trailing, but with the football here to start the fourth.
We couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, 1-score game, first and 10 here.
On a huge mistake late, it's intercepted. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. And the Ravens are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line.
Brandon, offensively, this has been a tough day for him. Trying to find a place to throw the football. It's been extremely difficult. I've got to give a lot of credit to the secondary, especially the corners who've had the receivers on lockdown.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out into some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Pretty ideal right there. Keeping yourself, get the first down, and get the heck out of bounds.
And knowing him, I believe he's thinking, I can get a few more yards if I just lower my shoulder. But he also hears that second voice in his head, his head coach, or probably his agent too, saying, get out of bounds, man. Don't do that. His running ability has been an extra dimension of their game plan thus far. For once, though, he doesn't create any magic against the front. They're prepared for him to try and take off.
second down and six now. They go play action with Jackson. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll run up the gut with Dobbins. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game.
10 yards on the pickup.
An ideal down and distance to try to finish this thing off. Second and inches. Off the play fake. Here's Jackson, and he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. In for the sack, Myles Garrett.
Brandon, that's just football 101. If you're out of the pocket, you've got to get rid of the football in this situation. You cannot take a sack in a two-minute drill.
Flushed out right, and he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game.
This is a little hard for me to compute because I'm watching sack after sack happen. But somehow, they're still behind in the game. I would expect all of this defensive pressure to translate to them taking a lead, and thus far, it hasn't happened. Time's winding down. They don't want to waste this type of performance from these ace pass rushers.
And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good, and this will stay a four-point game. Now, this was still going to be a one-score game either way, but still, that's a potentially harmful miss here in the fourth.
It certainly is, because if you consider that now if they give up a touchdown, they give up the lead. So he might be getting the side eye by the defenders coming out on the field now as he goes back to the bench after that miss. And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team.
Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. Picked off by Arthur Maulet. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown.
Well, I mean, both offenses have clearly struggled throughout, so kind of fitting that it's another big defensive play that yields points here in the late going.
Yeah, really, both of these defenses have been up to the task throughout this game, and we haven't seen much in terms of offensive creativity or results. And there, not only does the defense force a turnover, but they have the presence of mind to take it back for 6 points.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. On the return from his end zone is Grant. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. They'll come up first and 10 here. Here's Watson. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Kyle Hamilton picks it. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
Watson.
We've got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college, and how about in the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
Down to a knee goes Jackson, and that should seal it.
So the final seconds tick away in this Baltimore victory. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last point of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all.